Hey guys, this is Paul with another installment of Late Night Games. Tonight we are playing Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, The Sith Lords. We're just gonna get started and create ourselves a new character. What class do I want to be? Definitely want to be a male. Although I do prefer watching women run around, I'm a guy and it'd be kind of weird to play in the mindset of a female with the very distinct voice of a man. Now the question is, do I want to be a guardian, a sentinel, or a consular? Consulars are masters of the force and spend less time on combat training, recommended for advanced players. Sentinels are well balanced and possess many skills. Guardians focused on combat training and lightsaber mastery. Let's go with a sentinel. Let's go with custom character. First, let's set our portrait. Do we want to be the Asian Jedi? The bald Jedi with the brilliant soul patch? This nice blonde fellow? This military looking guy with a scar on his eye? The Kyle Katarn of the Jedi? Looks kind of like a Weasley. And let's see. Kind of like him. We're back to the beginning. I say the one I like the most is the Kyle Katarn looking one. As old school as that is, I kind of like the facial hair look. Attributes. The attributes of your character apply bonuses or penalties to everything from combat to skill checks or force powers. Check each attribute to see what aspects of the game it can affect. I have 30 points. It costs 1 point for strength. 10 is neutral. This appears very similar to the way characters are built in Dungeons & Dragons, actually, where every 2 points gives you a plus 1 modifier, and then once you get above 14 skill points, it costs twice as much to update it. So it's like a buy 30 type of D20 system. So let's go. Melee damage, chance to hit. I'm gonna reduce the background music while we're going through this. There we go, that should be a little better. So let's start with strength. Also increases your accuracy with a close combat weapon. Dex adds to blasters and to evasion. Constitution adds health gained at each level up and what type of implants you can use. Intelligence adds to modifiers for reasoning. Wisdom represents their ability to modify the force, it looks like, and for wisdom and magic saving throws. And charisma increases the potency of force powers and reduces the penalty when using force powers of an opposing alignment. It also improves your companion's chance to hit and influences the persuade ability. Well, since I do love the Jedi mind tricks, I'll put this up to 12 to start. Give me a plus 1 modifier. I want to bring everything else to 0. I don't want any penalties. Which gives me 16 points left to spend. I'm going to go with strength up to 14. Constitution as well. And intelligence. I can either give my dex a plus 1, my wisdom a plus 1, my charisma plus 2, or I might be able to... Actually, I could do either dex, wisdom, and charisma, any two of those, or increase any of these plus 2s to a plus 3, it looks like. Yeah, I can increase a plus 2 to a plus 3, so... I'll give him a plus 2 in dex. So he's not very wise, not very good at resisting the force, so I'm very sensitive to the Force impacting me, but I'm strong, quick, got good constitution, I'm smart, I'm slightly charismatic. Let's go with skills next. Alright. Yeah, this is definitely a D20 type system. You open a lock with a DC 15, you take your skill plus wisdom plus D20. If the total is 15 or greater, the lock's opened. Sorry about the constant coughing, I'm having a bit of a tickle in my throat today. Class skills cost 1 point to increase, while non-class skills cost 2. What are the recommended? Recommends 4 in computer use, 4 in stealth, 4 in awareness, 4 in persuade, and 4 in security. Which is like locking devices and whatnot. Let me reduce security and stealth. And instead throw those 4 points into treat injury. I want to be able to heal myself. Back up, because that's for opening doors and lockpicking, so I want to keep that nice and high, but stealth I can do without. It also affects your ability to use I don't feel like stealthing. And feats. You have been granted the following feats this level. Light proficiency and armor proficiency for light armor, critical strikes, flurries, power attack, power blast, rapid shot, sniper shot, blaster pistol proficiency, blaster rifle proficiency, lightsaber proficiency, melee weapons, Jedi defense, force immunity to fear, Jedi sense, war veteran, and that's it. Now, I can add one additional feat. I just want to see what all of these do. Jedi Sense, gives a +2 bonus to defense. Force immunity helps prevent fear. Jedi defense only works when I have a lightsaber equipped, and it's, I guess, the Jedi's ability to block things with a lightsaber. Melee weapon proficiency lets me use melee, lightsaber, rifles, pistols. Sniper shot, increases the crit range of an attack. Rapid shot, allows the character to make an extra ranged attack. Character suffer -4 to defense while using it, and for 3 seconds afterwards. And they also suffer -4 to their attacks that round. Power blast increases damage, but then gives you a penalty to accuracy. Power attack, same thing, but with melee. Flurry is the same as rapid shot, but with melee. Light armor proficiency lets me wear light armor. Characters without this feat cannot wear light or heavier armor. Wookiees and droids cannot wear armor suits. Makes sense. Dual weapon fighting. This feat reduces the attack penalty of a character wielding a double-bladed weapon or 2 weapons, one in each hand. Normal penalties of -6 and -10 are reduced to 0 and 4, for a total of -6, -6. Use of a balanced weapon in the offhand can further reduce the attack penalty by 2-0 to a total of -4, -6. So, you still suffer a penalty. Improved Master. Nice. With Master 2 weapon fighting, you can almost entirely negate the negative. Caution gives you a +1 to demolitions and stealth. Empathy is to persuade, awareness, and treat injury. Gearhead is good for repair, security, computer use. Conditioning is to all saving throws. Toughness adds an extra vitality point. Dueling Plus one attack and plus one to defense due to the efficiency of this form of combat. Demolitions, repair. Close combat requires level 4, so I can't do that. Dual strike. Finesse for lightsabers. They can add dex or strength, whichever is higher. Ability, regenerate. Alright. I am going to go with... I'm going to play this character as a guy who uses a blaster pistol or a single weapon. That being said, I'm going to go with dueling because the single melee weapon... Oh, this applies to both ranged and melee weapons. So as long as I'm using a one-handed weapon, it gives me a plus one to attack and defense. That's what I'm going to do, because I'm going to be either using a pistol or a lightsaber. I ain't doing no big heavy guns. Name. Let's name him Loki Ramos. And play. Let's see how the beginning of this game is, and we'll probably cut this episode short because we just spent God knows how long creating a character. A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. The Sith Lords. It is a perilous time for the galaxy. A brutal civil war has all but destroyed the Jedi Order, leaving the ailing Republic on the verge of collapse. Amid the turmoil, the evil Sith have spread across the galaxy, hunting down and destroying the remaining Jedi Knights. Narrowly escaping a deadly Sith ambush, the last known Jedi clings to life aboard a battered freighter near the ravaged world of Paragus. And if you can still read that, you don't need glasses. This medley brings back all the feels, all the nostalgia. Love it. Drives offline.
Multiple hull breaches detected.
Where am I?
Proximity alert.
Uh-oh, I'm gonna crash. What am I gonna crash into, though? Oh, it's
the
little droid.
The Ebon Hawk is adrift in space after a terrible battle. Most of its crew are dead or dying. You lie in the medical room in critical condition. You won't survive long without medical attention. The hyperdrive is damaged. Main power must be restored in order to bring the engine online and dock with the nearby Paragus mining station for much needed repair. Your fate and that of the Ebon Hawk depend upon T3M4, a lone astromech droid. Return to this location at any time to skip the prologue.
I am going to continue the prologue, and we'll do the prologue as the duration of our video today.
Press W, A, S, D to move T3M4, then turn. Press Caps Lock to toggle first person free look. Hold Control to look about. You have new quests. To view your quests, open the game menu, default escape. And look in the journal, default J.
Cool. I like this first person mode. Can't move while you're in first person mode.
This room contains the glass seal cylinder and the communications console. To target one of these objects, move close to it, left click on it, or press Q or E to cycle through an available target. To interact with an object,
you can use your mouse to select eligible targets. While in combat, only hostiles will be targetable. I got a computer spike.
You will come across many containers, some of which will be locked. The computer spike you just picked up can be used at computer terminals to access functions, such as opening doors.
Thank you, computer. I will grab this communication console. Use your left mouse button to continue. I am going to use my computer knowledge to slice the system. Open the main hold containment door. Log out. I used up the computer spike, but now the door is open. Da 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 da, I'm a little droid. Footlocker is currently locked. Security console. I do not have enough spikes to perform the operation. And that is locked. Broken droid. I will get the parts from it. Low security door is locked.
Some doors can be bashed open or cut open with a lightsaber or cutting tool. Some doors require you can hear a banging noise coming from the other side of the door to the storage compartment. But the door is sealed shut and cannot be opened from the outside. If you need help exploring the Ebon Hawk, access the map screen by pressing
A. Let's continue exploring and see if we can find some more computer spikes.
This will take you to outer hull of the Ebon Hawk, where you will find many parts and mines to use for accessing and repairing the hyperdrive. Use the lift.
Alright, let's fix that hyperdrive up.
This is the utility lift. You can use this lift.
Go outside. Controls are a little finicky, but it's an older game, so what can you really expect? Some of them have some finicky controls. Haha, I am outside the ship now. Ooh, wow. Yeah, this thing suffered some major damage. Like, oh my god.
This is the starboard side of the Ebon Hawk. This open hatch has some parts that will be useful for getting main power restored.
Engine port. Come on, mouse. Don't fail me now. Ooh, lots of parts.
This engine port has some needed parts for the Ebon Hawk's hyperdrive. Take the parts here back down below to get main power restored.
Okay, that's everything within sight.
Don't forget to explore. This is the port side of the Ebon Hawk.
I'm going to recover this mine.
The bubbles ahead indicate mines that you've detected automatically with your awareness. Approach mines carefully. They will blow up and damage you if you get... Recovering mines requires a higher demolition skill than disabling them.
Okay. I will recover the mine. Yay! Recover. Huzzah! A minor frag mine and some parts.
You can use an explosive device in this missile to blow open the engine room door inside the Ebon Hawk.
Haha!
You access to the hyperdrive. You can
That's
use
good
the
to know.
To take...
I will go back inside.
This is the engine room.
Let's mine the door. Kablooey! I am in the engine room.
The starboard engine is badly damaged. Fixing it won't be possible until after docking with the Paragon mining station. The hyperdrive is suffering badly. Won't be able to make the jump to light speed until it, however, you should be able to rig the hyperdrive to restore primary power and bring the port engine online.
Alright, I will rig the hyperdrive, because I have lots of parts.
The hyperdrive is online.
Primary power is restored.
Only one step remains.
Thank you, good old droid.
This is the garage.
Garage is locked. I have hacked this door.
Cargo hold. Talking to other characters is much like using a computer console in a cockpit. Note that some responses may influence. Furthermore, certain skills, powers, and attributes may modify what choices you have, or how successful you are with them.
I'm gonna talk to this droid.
3CFD is malfunctioning. If you repair 3CFD,
I'm gonna repair him. Redeet doot, redeet deet beet. Yes, I would love if you join me. Together we'll fix the Ebon Hawk. Follow me if you wish, but if you slow me down, I'll jettison you, or no, I don't want you to join me. Yes, follow me. Tree-tee-tee-tee.
You chose a response that 3CFD likes. If you continue... 3CFD is now a member of your party. To change which party member you control, click on the portrait.
Hack the box.
Tab. Later, when you have more... Exodroids emerge from this box when you opened it. These droids will make for excellent targets. You can equip a weapon from the equip screen. To open the equip screen...
Alright, so I just got that new weapon. I'm going to equip the field survival pistol. There we go. And I'll equip that. There we go. Now I've got a pistol equipped.
Click on the blaster icon in the top right area of the screen.
That's pause. Okay, I will attack this droid. Attack. Remember, only left click the targeted enemy once to engage. You'll automatically attack. Do not have to left click. Oh, and now I unpause.
Hit your target by pressing 2 or 2. Or left click on the object you want to target. Attacking the enemy is worth achieving the sensor droids. To continue combat training, open the metal box again, and more sensor droids will appear.
A high security cylinder. Can I unlock this?
The lock on this container is too difficult to open. You'll need to use a security tunneler to help open the lock. Look in the unlocked cylinder. If you encounter a difficult lock on a container or door, you can...
Now I can use the multiple power items of a security tunneler. Haha! And now it's open. Components and computer spike. A locker. What's in the locker? I'm just gonna use a basic unlock on that.
This container is locked and requires a key. Search the ship. Find a key.
Requires a key, eh?
This is the main hold.
Low security door. Open sesame! You as well. Open sesame! Hey, look, it's me.
You are in critical condition.
I must stabilize myself. Get the med pack.
The med pack can stabilize your condition.
I will treat his injuries.
Success! You are stabilized. To recover fully, you will require the medical facility.
No longer in danger of dying. I like not being in danger of dying.
cargo hold.
Already been here.
This is the garage. Access the area beyond this door. You will have to use the solo mode. Click the solo mode button at the bottom right area of the screen. To access the area beyond this door, you will have to use solo mode. This is the garage.
Beautiful. Alright. And now I will use this guy. Oh, that's cool.
This is the engine room. This is the main hold.
Unlock this.
Your security skill is too low to...
Well, then I will bash it. Bash it away. Bash it. Bash. Haha. And I got the computer spikes.
Sometimes bashing or blowing open the container will break some of the items in the container. But you can use even broken items.
I will slice the system. Okay. Access security doors. One moment. That was weird. I could have sworn I heard a rap, rap, rapping on my chamber door. I will open the outer garage door. I will open the inner garage door. Oh, first I gotta close the outer. Close. Enter. Open. Haha! Now I log out. Hit tab. This little fellow.
This is a workbench. With a workbench, you can break down objects in your inventory. Because of the damage to the Ebon Hawk, this workbench has limited function. Use the workbench to...
Aha! I can use the workbench to create a repair kit. Alright. I'm not gonna use the repair kit. To repair myself. And now I'm fully healed.
You can use repair kits to heal droids like yourself. To use a repair kit, click on the repair kit on the bottom of the screen or press 5.
Pretty. Look at that. Oh wow, look at that planet. It got blowed up real good. I wonder if that's what hit me.
This blast door is magnetically sealed and cannot be opened. When the Ebon Hawk has landed, this is where you will go to exit the ship. This door is sealed shut, but the magnetic clamps are not engaged. You may be able to override the door's locking mechanism from outside the ship.
Well then, let's try that. Little droid, let's take you outside and see if we can disable the locking mechanism.
You can use this lift to take you to...
I'm really liking this ability to split your party up and basically perform multiple functions. Oh, but as soon as I went outside, it,
This is the port side of the Ebon Hawk.
Quadra lasers. Parts.
This is one of the Ebon Hawk's quad laser turrets. They are damaged, but you can scavenge some parts from it to use in repairing the Ebon Hawk.
There you go.
This is the starboard side. This is the starboard side of the Ebon Hawk.
exposed wires.
These exposed wires control the door to the starboard dormitory. The door is...
Override the door!
Yes, the door is open.
Huzzah! Huzzah indeed. Come on. Up you go.
You can use this lift.
I will go back inside. Now I'm gonna go back to that security terminal. And then get my droid inside the... Whatever that was I just unlocked. No, not through the engine. Switch to solo mode, console, access security doors, close the inner, open the outer, log out, switch to 3CFD, because 3CFD is the man, well, the droid, but the man.
This is the garage.
Switch. I want to access doors, close, open, log out, switch. More parts. A droid flamethrower.
This is one of the special weapons the droids can use. To equip it, open the equip screen by clicking on the...
I am so equipping this. Droid flamethrower. Okay. Yeah.
Capture icons in the top right area of the screen or press...
R2-D2 eat your heart out, now I've got a frickin' flamethrower.
When the Ebon Hawk has landed, this is where you will
I'd like
go
you to see you be all
the
flamethrower-y.
These sparking wires connect to the trigger mechanism for the inner...
I will... open the outer.
You can't open the outer garage door without depressurizing the... Do you want to do an...
Alright, I will switch back to you. Security doors. Close. Open. Log out. Disable solo mode. Which causes him to come running back to me. Ooh, locker key.
Appears to be dead. There is a key card on the body that looks like it of this blast door is magnetically sealed.
Where was that locker I saw? If I remember correctly, it was in the storage room.
This is the cargo hold.
Use the key I found. Computer spike droid impact armor. Hell yes. Plating, impact armor. Yeah. This is one tricked out droid. I say this has been a very successful prologue. Let's get ourselves back to the main area. Since I believe we've done everything we can here.
There is nothing more you can do.
Well.
This is the cockpit. You can now plot a course to the Paragus mining station.
Now let's find Paragus. Travel. Thank you. Go Little Intrepid Droid single-handedly rebuilt the ship to the point where it could land and dock, treated me so I didn't die, and got us all here safe. And he upgraded himself.
The sensors show the door to the storage compartment is being sliced. There is someone, or something, else alive on the Ebon Hawk.
I'm glad I'm well equipped. What is that? You. I am not a meat bag. Not sure what just happened there. Am I in a Bacta tank? He's about to wake up. And this is where we're going to cut it off for today. Tune in next time as we see what happens when we finally wake up. Oh, I can't stop. I gotta watch it. I love the red sneakers. They just totally sell it for me. And that is where we're going to leave off, folks. Thank you again for tuning in to Late Night Games. Join us next time as we finally take control of the intrepid Jedi, Loki Ramos, and see where exactly it is he woke up, and what happened to our faithful savior of a droid. And what was that big, ugly-looking droid with the gun? Find out the answer to this the next time we play Knights of the Old Republic 2. Make sure to check us out on Facebook and Twitter. Subscribe to this video channel if you haven't already, and like this video if you like what you see. Leave any comments you have down in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for tuning in.